17:00 a.m. And this is a meeting, a special meeting of the Edina City Council to canvass the vote that took place on the general election on November 5th, 2024. I'm going to call this meeting to order, and I'm going to ask our clerk, Sharon Allison, to call the roll.
Here.
Here.
Here. Next, we have a meeting agenda to approve. Is there a motion to approve the meeting agenda?
So moved. Second.
Member Agnew moves the approval of the meeting agenda. Member Jackson seconds. Any further discussion? All those in favor of approving the meeting agenda, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried. The meeting agenda is adopted. We have one item here, as I mentioned, the canvassing of the vote, the results of the municipal election held November 5th, 2024, and that's in the reports and recommendations portion of the agenda. It's embodied in Resolution 2024-97, which our city clerk, Sharon Allison, will now present to us. Clerk Allison.
Mayor, council members, thanks for having me this morning. You are here, as the mayor stated, to canvass or approve the results of the general election. And here is the results. Congratulations, Mayor Hovland, on being elected to another term. Congratulations, Councilmember Jackson and Councilmember Pierce, on being elected to another term. Before you approve the elections, though, I'd like to share some data with you and other information about the elections. So actual turnout was 86%, which is actually within the range of what we normally see in Edina. In 2020, we did have a high of 90%, but generally, it's between 75% and 86% is what we've seen. Early voting, though, we had 59%. That is extremely high for Edina. And then on election day, 41% of voters went to their polling place to vote. In terms of the voters who came to City Hall, we had 15,054 voters that voted at City Hall. In the first 4 weeks, we had just a little bit over 3,700 that voted, and that daily average was 171. Now, in the first 4 weeks, that's the time period when voters are filling out their ballot and putting it into the envelope to be sent to the county and counted later. As you can see, in the last 2 weeks, when voters are able to put their ballot into the ballot counter, that is the period when voters are more interested in voting, with 11,294 voters coming to City Hall. And that was a daily average of 753, an extremely high number. Our two highest days were November 1st, where we had 1,138 voters, and then on November 4th, the day before election, where we had 1,147 voters in City Hall. I'd like to thank the staff, nearly 200 people that made this election possible. We had about 167 election judges, and then the rest were actual full-time city staff that helps out with the election process. And we definitely could not make this election work without this village that we needed in order to pull off a successful election in Edina. So thank you all who helped out. I'd like to show you a year-by-year comparison. You may recall that in 2016, that's the first year that voters were able to vote without an excuse. And just to show a comparison of 2016 to 2024, we had the exact same turnout. The only difference is that for early voting, it flipped with what we saw in 2024. Way more people chose to early vote in 2024 compared to 2016. What the data really showing us here is that there's a really high interest for voting early. And what that really does for us is that it creates some challenges. With City Hall then being a polling place for early voters, it creates some challenges in terms of what I have to do here at City Hall. Parking, for example. There just isn't enough parking for employees alone, let alone to accommodate all the voters that are coming to City Hall. So for the employees, I actually got approval from the city manager to have as many employees work from home as possible, just so that we could free up some parking spaces. The voting space is right here in the council chambers. It has gotten small. It is just not big enough to accommodate the number of voters that we're seeing. It is a lot of work to make the space work for voting in terms of setting and resetting the space when there are meetings and then having to reset for voting. In terms of the voters, I do believe that the voters had a great experience coming to City Hall. We pivoted so that they would not even feel the tension, the challenges that we're experiencing. In the lobby, for example, I changed the lobby several times just to make sure that I could accommodate employees coming and going and other customers coming and going at the same time that we are accommodating the voters. And voters were very grateful that we made it possible for them to be able to vote early. But still challenges that we'll need to talk about as you look at the numbers here. Luckily, we don't have another election until 26 and the presidential election in 28. So we do have some time to work on some of these challenges that we've experienced. And with that, I'll stand for any questions you have or ask you to approve the resolution as presented.
Any questions for Clerk Ellison or comments, Commissioner? Councilmember Jackson.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So when we're looking at this going forward in the voting space, one of the questions I will have is, are there any constraints on moving this to our new fire station number 2? I know when we looked at the site design of that building, one of the things we had in mind was being able to do early voting there to take that out of City Hall. And so you don't have to have an answer now, but that's one of the things I would like to see if it's legally possible and logistically possible.
It is legally possible to have a new site for absentee voting. Logistically, that's what we'll have to look at to make sure that will work.
Terrific. Thank you.
All right. I don't have anything further either. Is there a motion to approve Resolution 2024-97, which canvassed the results of the municipal election in the city of Edina held November 5th, 2024?
So moved.
A second.
Member Jackson moves. Member Agnew seconds the motion to approve Resolution 2024-97, which canvasses the results of the municipal election held November 5th, 2024 in the city of Edina. Any further discussion? All those in favor of adoption of the motion as stated, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried. The motion is adopted. The canvassing is approved. Resolution 2024-97. Thank you. Anything further, Clerk Ellison?
No, Mr. Mayor.
All right. Is there a motion to adjourn this meeting of the City Council this Thursday, November 14, 2024?
So moved. Second.
Member Agnew moves. Member Jackson seconds the adjournment of the meeting of the City Council this 14th day of November 2024. Any further discussion? All those in favor of adjournment, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried. We stand adjourned.